the last video, we had discussed about spot market, wherein we discussed about the cross rates. When we have got multiple exchanges and multiple currencies, how to take advantage of the situation that we had discussed in the last session. In this session, we will try to discuss about interest rate arbitrage, or call that as a covered interest rate arbitrage. Basically, when interests are same, or when the market is same, interest cannot be different. If the interests are different, an investor can take an advantage of the situation. This kind of problems we will try to discuss here. So we call that as a covered interest rate arbitrage. Okay. So problem goes like this. Given the following data, the actual spot rate rupees 42.0010 per dollar, 6 months forward rate rupees 42.8020, annualized interest rate for 6 months rupees in rupees it's 12%, annualized interest rate for 6 months dollar it is 8%. Calculate arbitrage possibility. This is what simple what they ask. Okay, the given what we need to take is first one, that is spot rate. Spot rate what they given? Rupee 42.0010 per dollar, and forward rate is 6 months forward rate. 6 months forward rate is rupees 42.8020 per dollar. Okay, then interest rate, rupee interest rate what that is, rupee interest rate is 12%, rupee interest rate 12%, whereas dollar interest rate lag when is 8%. With this information, they ask us to find out, is there any arbitrage possibilities? Okay. So first, what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to find the, is there any arbitrage possibility or not. For this, we have one rule. First, we need to understand this rule. The rule, what it says is, the rule is that if the interest rate differential, is greater than premium or discount, then part in the country, inflow should go into the country or is the money in the country that has the highest rate of interest. That is, we have to borrow in a country, where interest rate is low and par where interest rate is high, or vice versa. To repeat again, the rule what it says is, if the interest rate differential is greater than the premium or discount, then place the money in the currency that has higher rate of interest, or vice versa. So for that, what we should do? We should find out two important things, that is interest rate differential, then we have to find out the premium or discount. So first thing, interest rate differential is interest rate differential is how much? That is 12% is rupee and 8% is, in case of dollar it is 8%, so interest differential comes to 4%. Interest differential is 4%. Okay, so then premium or discount, calculation of premium or discount is, we need to calculate the premium or discount. We know how to calculate already. Premium or discount is equal to forward rate minus spot rate divided by spot rate into 12 by
n into 100. Okay. So forward rate is 42.8020. You can see here this is the forward rate 42.8020 minus 42.0010 divided by 42.0010 into 100 into 12 divided by n is for how many months? 6 months. 12 divided by 6 into 100. Okay. If you calculate this premium straight discount, this is equal to minus 3.8141. Okay. So premium discount is, we should take absolute amount, whether it's a positive or negative, we should not bother. We'll take absolute amount 3.8141 and interest differential is 4%. Okay. If interest rate differential is greater than the premium discount, then what we should do? We should borrow in a country where interest is less and park the money in a country where interest is high. In this case, in which country interest rate is low? In case of US, interest is low. In case of India, it is interest rate is high. We have to borrow in US and we have to park the amount in, we have to park the amount in case of India. Okay. Let's see how exactly it works. Okay. From the above, you can see that the rate differential 4% is greater than the 4 premium discount. Hence, there is a possibility of arbitrage inflow in India. So, we'll evaluate this one. How exactly is possible? So, let's evaluate. Arbitrage possibility for assumption is dollar 1000. That is, it's an assumed amount for dollar 1000. Just we are making a hypothetical assumption that amount what we are investing is dollar 1000. Step 1, what we do? Step 1. Borrow dollar thousand at 8%. As you know, interest rate in US is 8% in US. Okay. Then step 2, convert dollar into rupee at the rate of 42.00 rupee 42.0010 per dollar. Hence, how much we'll have? How much investor will have? And investor will have 42,001. So if you convert $1,000 into 42.0010, so we can see the calculation. $1 is equal to 42.0010 for $1,000 is equal to how much? If you make cross multiplication, 1000 into 42.0010 divided by 1, will answer as 42,001. Then step 3, invest in India at the rate of, so what is the rate of interest in India? It is basically, we mentioned this in India, the rate of interest is rate of interest what they have is 12%. 12%. Hence, amount at the end of 6 months. 6 months equals to how much we are investing? 42,001 into 12 by 100. For how many months we are investing? Well, she was 6 months into 6 by 12. That comes to 2520.06. Okay, so interest and principal together 42,001 plus 2520.06 is equal to 44,581.06. Okay, step 4, convert rupee into dollar at forward rate, at forward rate of 42.8020. Okay, so $1 is equal to $1 is equal to 42.8020. So rupee 42.20. Now much we have 44,521.06 is equal to how much? If you make all the cross multiplication, we get 44,521.06 divided by 42.8020. If you do this exercise, you get answer as $1040.16. Okay, 1040.16. This is if you convert rupee back to the dollar. Then the last two steps we left out. Step 5. So we'll make calculation of interest on amount borrowed is equal to 1,000 rupees we borrowed at the rate of 8%, 8 by 100 to 6 by 12. If you do that, we get answer as 40. Okay, then lastly, arbitrage profit is equal to how much you got. So totally $1,040.16 is equal to $1,040.16 minus 1,000 rupees of principal amount plus interest, what is supposed to be 40. So it comes to arbitrage profit is equal to $0.16. Okay, to summarize again this problem, when interest differential is greater than prima discount, what we should do? We should borrow in a country where interest is less and should park in a country where interest is more. In this problem, interest rate is less in the US. We want to borrow, hypothetically we borrow 1000 rupees in US at rate of 8%. Then we convert into Indian rupee. When we convert into Indian rupee, we get a 42,001 rupee. This 42,001 rupee, we want to park in India at rate of 12% for 6 months. If you park India at rate of 12% for 6 months, you got interest as 2520.06. So interest and principal at the end of 6 months, we get a 44,521.06. So at the end of 6 months, how much will have? 44,521.06. So at the end of 6 months, what we do? We know already forward rate, that is 42.8020. At the forward rate, we convert the rupee into dollar, when you convert rupee into dollar, you get a 1040.16. This 1040.16, so out of this 1040.16, we have to pay interest. If you calculate the interest, what the amount we borrowed, 1000 rupees, no? On that interest, what you get is 40. Okay? So 1000 plus 40, 1000 rupees principal amount we have to repay to the bank. Then 40 rupees as interest we have to repay. Total amount which we are supposed to repay to the bank is 1040. So how much amount by converting from a rupee to dollar and dollar back to the rupee? So you got a 1040.16 minus 1040. You got an arbitrary profit of $0.16. That's the this problem. So how to take an advantage when there is an interest rate differential. Thank you. We'll move to the next problem. Yeah, the slide has disappeared on the screen. There we have mentioned the problem. The problem goes like this. I read the problem. You also on the screen is there. On screen, the problem is there. Read the question. An American firm purchases $4,000 worth of perfume, that is French franc 20,000 for a French firm. The American distributor must make the payment in 90 days in French franc. Okay, the following quotation and expectations exist for French franc. Present spot rate is $0.2000. US interest rate is 15%. And 90 days French forward rate is 0.2200. French interest rate is 10%. Your expectation of the spot rate is 90 days. Hence 0.2400 is the expected spot rate. The question what they are asking is, what is the premium or discount for French franc? What is the interest rate differential between US and France? Is there any interest for CIA, covered interest rate arbitrage? If there is CIA, how can arbitrator take the advantage of the situation? Assume the arbitrator is willing to borrow $4,000 or French franc 20,000. There are no transaction costs initially. If the transaction costs are 50 rupees, would the opportunity still exist for CIA? This is what the entire question is all about. Just is there on screen, the problem is there. Just all of you read the question very carefully. Okay, chemical solution of this problem. First, what we should do? We should calculate the forward premium or discount. Okay. So, as we know, the formula is forward rate minus spot rate divided by spot rate into 12 by n into 100. So forward rate is how much? 22 minus 20 divided by 20 into 12 by n by 3 into 100. The answer what we get is 40%. Answer what we get is 40%. Okay. So what is the interest rate differential? Interest rate differential is 15% and 10%. Okay. So what the rule says? If interest differential is greater than the premium discount, then borrow in the country where interest is less and park in the country where interest is more. But here reverse is case. Here interest differential is lesser than the premium discount, so we have to reverse. Borrow in a country where interest rate differential is, borrow in a country where interest rate is high and park in a country where interest is low. So let's evaluate that one. That is the second question. What they are asking is there any CIA, the cover interest arbitrage? Yes, of course, we have possibility of CIA. The arbitrager can take the advantage in the following manner. So what they are asking is, first they are asking you to find out, is there any CIA? If there is CIA, how can an arbitrager take an advantage of the situation? Okay, let's see how the arbitrager can take advantage of the situation. Yes, come back. Step 1, basically we have to borrow the amount in a country where interest rate is high. Will you borrow in America? Borrow $4,000. Borrow $4,000 for 90 days. Okay. Step 2, what we are doing? Convert dollar to French franc, dollar to French franc at spot rate of dollar 0.200 per French franc. Okay, so one French franc is equal to dollar 0.200. Okay, so $4,000 is equal to how much? If you cross multiply 4000 into 1 divided by 0.200, so answer what we get is French franc $20,000. Okay, so if you convert dollar into French franc, you get a French franc $20,000. Third step is invest French franc in France for 90 days. For 90 days at 10%. So hence investor will have an amount equals to how much will he will have? 20,000 into 10/100 into 3/12. Okay, so how much will have? You will have 500. Okay, so totally 20,000 plus 500 will have 20,500. Will have French franc 20,500. The first step is we'll convert French franc into dollar at forward rate of 0.000. Okay, so therefore one French franc is equal to dollar 0.2200. So how many French francs you have? 20,500 is equal to how much? Okay. So if you make cross multiplication, 20,500 into 0.22, you get answer as $4,510. You get dollar as $4,510. Okay. Next one is calculate interest. Interest and amount to be repaid. So how much amount we have borrowed? We have borrowed 4,000. Okay, 4,000 into the interest of 12%. So how much amount we need to repay now? 4,000 plus 150 is equal to $4,150 we have to repay. Okay. So arbitrage profit is so how much amount we gained? How much amount we got? 4,510 minus amount. How much amount we need to pay? 4,150. The net gain. Still the net gain what we have is $360. So $360 is the net gain. I repeat again. The entire problem I repeat again. Here in this case interest rate differential. If interest rate differential is greater than the premium discount, then we have to borrow in a country where interest is less and park in a country where interest is more. But in the reverse case here, interest differential is lesser than the premium discount. So we have to borrow in a country where interest is high and park in a country where interest is low. So we know for that reason we are borrowing 4,000. We have to borrow $4,000 or we have to borrow 20,000 French francs. So we are borrowing $4,000 because so interest is high in US. We are going to borrow 4,000 for 90 days and then we are going to convert this one 4,000 to French franc. We get 27 French franc. So this French franc we are going to invest in France for a period of 90 days at a rate of 10%. Then we are going to get an interest of 500 rupees and principal amount of 27. So 27,500 rupees we have at the end of 90 days. And that amount we are going to convert into dollar at a forward rate of 0.2200. So then we are going to realize an amount of $4,510. Okay. So, but interest we need to pay for on the amount what we borrowed. The amount of 4,000 what we borrowed, we have to pay interest of 150 plus 4,000. What we get? 4,150. So we are supposed to repay back to the bank. But whereas we earned a 4,510. 4,510. Minus 4,150. So if we deduct, so totally how much arbitrage profit will have? $360. Okay. And the last question what they are asking is, if the transaction cost of rupees 50, would any opportunity still exist for CIA? So initially what they said, there is no transaction cost. If the transaction cost is $50. So that's the still there is an arbitrage profit. Yes, still there is an arbitrage profit because so amount what you earned is $360 as a profit minus 50 if you take out, then also we have 310 as an arbitrage profit. So we can write, even though the transaction cost 50 is present, still we can say that still there is existed arbitrage profit. Thus completes this interest covered interest rate arbitrage. Thank you for watching.